So I'm in Kalkallo now doing a frame inspection. Let's go and see if this frame is compliant to the stamp drawings and the National Construction Codes. Let's go. So basically we have a double story home here. So we're gonna go through the engineering documents and then see if the works does match the plans. Let's go. So we got here the front porch area. It says it requires that the frame to the porch must be H3 treated. Let's check it out. So this is the front right here, and the timbers are H3 treated. This is the stamp, as you can see right there. Now I also noticed that the bottom plate is not continuous, it has been cut. The engineer does have a detail here right there for a discontinued bottom plate, and it states 250mm max. Let's measure what we've got here. It's 175, and you have to put some masonry nails on either side, and there's nothing there. So then here we have a frame that's overhanging the slab, and the structural drawings does state that if there's a bottom plate overhanging 11 to 20mm, you have to put structural grout. And here we have 11mm. So looking around the slab, the vapor barrier has been brought all the way up. Some sections it needs to be repaired, like here and here. So take a look at this. This is a load bearing wall right here, double stud. And look what they've done here.
They've actually drilled holes through the supporting members. Okay, let's bring up AS1684 and have a look at the requirements for grading holes. You can see H here, it's highlighted for you guys. And on the table, it also states that the maximum hole allowance is 25mm. Now, I like to use this taper gauge, which is like a ruler. It can fit anywhere. It is available in our online store, and you can see that the hole is 50mm in this hole and around 35mm for this hole.
So basically an engineer has to be consulted about the rectification method for this item right there. And also this web here has been disconnected, as you can see. So the manufacturer must be consulted with in order to repair this. So they've also attempted to repair this joist here, as you can see. More discontinuous bottom plate. Now let's check out upstairs. So we've got a double lintel right here that's not being laminated. It's only been laminated on one side. However, if you look at the manufacturer's installation guide, it does state that it has to be both sides like that. But this is the table here. You can see if you're using nails, for spacing, screws or bolts. So we've also got a gang nail that's been delaminating here, a bracket that's not even fixed, another gang nail as well, and also here as well, this one's coming apart. And what the hell is going on here? So see where I've got my tape measure sitting? That's a valley truss. And you can see that there is no support of that truss. Now take a look at this. Now AS4440, which is the installation of nail plated timber roof trusses, states the following. So if it's more than 450 span, it needs to have blocking infill, as you can see right there. So as you can see here, it's spanning around 460.
Non-compliant.
All right, so thank God for the safety rail. Now I can see a better view. So can anybody see what's going on here? So this part of the truss is called the hip, right there.
And this is a creeper truss.
So have a look at this extract from MyTech. It says that always fix the shorter leg off the creeper connector to the hip. So this short section there should be connected to the hip. And the longer leg of that clip should be connected to that jack or cutoff cord. So the longer bit has to be connected to this part here. So these are installed the other way around. And this one and this one. And also check out this girder truss right here. It's cracked. This needs to be repaired as well. Can anybody tell me what's wrong here? This is called a truss grip, and it is a fast way to anchor the truss to the top plate. Yep, they fixed it from the inside instead of the outside. As you can see from the picture, it should be fixed from the outside. That's why they're actually bending them in order for it to connect. Look at that. Now, this is throughout the whole job. Look at this. Look at that. Everywhere is the same thing. Also, take a look at this flooring. Now, because this frame is being exposed to the weather, the nails that are fixed to the floors everywhere here must be galvanized. And as you can see, they're not galvanized at all. You can see how they're rusting already. And also, if you're using a nail gun to machine fix those nails, the nail cannot penetrate the surface more than 1 mil. Here we have about 5 mil, and here we have about 3 mil. So that's common throughout the whole area here. And here's an extract print screen if you like. And you can see the Australian standards where it says right there. Have a look here. So other than that, look, the frame is okay. I mean, there's always gonna be defects. Let's go.